While addressing journalists at Parliament, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, described the two NUP legislators as confused and dishonest MPs who are self-seekers and shouldn't be taken seriously.
And when you listen to the two honourable members, with due respect, your critical media, do you read a sense of consistency on their faces and speech? Do you read any consistency in their speech and demeanour? I think these are members only the counselling. Actually, even if they went to MK permanently, they will need counselling. I don't think they are okay. And for me, as the leader of the opposition, what is most critical is that the people of Uganda elected them. Those same people are still there. Those same people have not had their aspirations or frustrations addressed. People will move by their stomachs. People will move by their appetite. They demand the key needs of the people that voted them remain. And at any one time presented, those people will make a choosing.
That he further challenged the same controversial lawmakers to dare and address their electorates on the political decision they took by associating with the MK movement as opposed to the NUP ideologies.
You can tell the country people probably have covered the MK. What is MK articulating? That does not really bother me. It only concerns me that some of our people are going to use our people over time, and it's very bad. No leader should use a platform offered to them for personal benefit. It's a very dangerous precedent, and I think our people are being awakened that in the future, you will have to cross-check the caliber of people that you vote for leaders. You know, it's very, very important. But I want to assure the people of Lugazi, the people of Onjeru. I was in Bukoto South over the weekend. It's not that's where I am born. I'm born of Bukoto South, where the Honorable Kagabo comes from. And I know that community quite well. They have not been bagged by an inch.
Meanwhile, the leader of opposition has also announced the remapping of his oversight tours in different parts of the country following the outcry of many Ugandans. Mpuuga revealed that remapping of the oversight visits will also consider the rescheduling of the already visited areas, and soon they will resume with Greater Masaka, back to Bunyoro, West Nile, Teso, Busoga, Chigezi, Ankole, and other regions.
We shall cover every breadth of this country. The whole idea is, even when the regime is dysfunctional as it is, people continue to pay taxes amidst a lot of strain and stress. And therefore, whoever claims to be a government must really make a case to prove they are worthy being in town. So we shall do that, and we owe nobody an apology. We do not owe anybody an apology for doing that.
The leader of opposition has further reminded the government to address the increasing insecurity in the country, especially in Greater Masaka, which has become a life-threatening habit in the country.
The robberies, the murders, speak of an absentee government. We demand nothing but action. And in areas where they claim that the robbery is occasioned by insurgents, we want to see them produced in court.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.